Good morning, everyone. My name is Justyna Skibińska, and you have made the research about wearable analytics for the purpose of early diagnostic of COVID-19 with the usage of machine learning and based on two cohorts. Let me begin by describing the agenda for the presentation. The motivation for this research will be presented in the beginning. Next, I will discuss the design of the experiments, which factors were taken into consideration, as well as the symptoms on COVID-19 detection. I will also mention a few sentences about the cohorts. The most important parts of the presentation are the results and main outcomes of the research. Then I will summarize the carried out experiment. I will begin by describing the symptoms of COVID-19. The time arrow depicts the development of COVID-19 symptoms over time. Detecting the disease at the earliest possible stage will potentially limit and decrease the number of contagious cases, which is highly important. Furthermore, the techniques that will be used should serve as screening tests. For this purpose, the usage of wearables seems to be justified. It could be explained by the fact that they are commonly available and relatively inexpensive. In addition, a few studies have been so far evaluated the use of wearables and machine learning methodologies for the analysis of COVID-19 disease. In some papers, the authors presented the disease stages of COVID-19. They distinguished between the early stage of infection, stage first, the pulmonary phase, stage second, and the hyperinflammation phase, stage third. The detection of the disease in the prodromal stage would have the most significant impact, since it affects the phase in which the person is infectious, but she or he feels healthy, which leads to social contacts and the spreading of the disease to other people. The authors indicated that symptoms in this phase included dry cough, fever, and anomalies in temperature and resting heart rate. The detection of the virus in this stage minimized contagiousness, preventing the development of further complications and reducing the duration of the disease. The risk factors for this disease are old age, civilization disease, and renal and hepatic dysfunction. One of the datasets was originally collected by Stanford University. These records contain the variable heart rate, the number of steps taken, and the stages of sleep. Nevertheless, the sleep-related data were missing. Anomaly detection was the subject of the study, and the authors achieved a sensitivity of 63%. For the purpose of classification, I have obtained among the publicly available dataset 27 COVID-19 cases, 54 healthy control, and 7 influenza cases. The distinction of COVID-19 cases from healthy control was equal to 78 of 100 accuracy, and the classification of COVID-19 cases, influenza, here flu, as one group versus healthy control was equal to 73 of 100 accuracy. This dataset was also merged in the research presented today, and it is the so-called dataset A. The results of the second original paper included three types of datasets. Wearable devices, in particular Fitbit smartwatches, were used to collect the data. Among them were exactly COVID-19 cases, non-COVID flu cases, and pre-COVID flu cases. The difference between non-COVID flu cases and pre-COVID flu cases is that the data were collected at different times and they were fitted to different types of viruses. The strain A and strain B types were distinguished. The cohort tried to be balanced to avoid overfitting. The data were reused. From the whole dataset, I have reused 21 COVID-19 patients, 37 non-COVID flu patients, and also 57 pre-COVID flu patients. This dataset is the so-called dataset B. In my previous research, I was dealing with the distinction of COVID-19 cases versus influenza during the pandemic, and I achieved 73 out of 100 balance accuracy. The differentiation between the flu cases was possible with 80 of 100 accuracy. The main difference between dataset A and dataset B is the sampling rate. Dataset A has higher sampling rate, 1 per minute and hour, whereas the sampling rate of dataset B is 1 per day. The dataset was collected by wearable devices. According to the second original paper, there occurred differences between the COVID-19 and influenza cases in duration and intensity of the disease in the dataset B. You can observe the differences on the slide. Vertical lines denote the median illness duration. Dataset A, thanks to the statistical analysis, shows a variety between the COVID-19 cases and healthy control based on the spectral and frequency features. Now I will go to the description of the evaluation of the experiment. The main goal of this experiment was to evaluate the accuracy of detecting COVID-19 disease or illness. The Fitbit device were used to record values about sleep, the number of steps, and heart rate. The overall process of the conducted experiment is visible on the graph. In the first step, dataset A was undersampled to 1 per day. Next, both datasets were combined. We used the time window in the range from 7 to 2 days before the reported onset of the disease by the patients, which was determined by the parameters like contagiousness parent and incubation. Additionally, the ratio of the extracted features between heart rate-related to activity-related features was computed. Next, the set of parameters was computed for the chosen window. To avoid the curse of dimensionality, the feature selection was carried out. It is minimum redundancy and maximum relevance. The number of features was set as 20. Subsequently, the classifier were used together with 10-fold cross-validation. They were XGBoost, KNN, support vector machines, logistic regression, decision tree, and random forest. The 6 scenarios were carried out for binary classification and multi-class classification. Finally, the outcome of the research was obtained. Here you can see, in the nutshell, the flow of the algorithm. It is presented the COVID-19 disease and influenza detection. The data were reused from Nature paper and from dataset B. The feature extraction step was described on the previous slide. The features, which were extracted from time series, were common statistical measurements like mean, standard deviation, residual standard deviation, maximum, minimum, range, variance, likewise time series specific parameters, Shannon entropy, approximate entropy, slow, skew, and kurtosis. Next, the machine learning step were evaluated. Additionally, some statistical evaluation was carried out. To track the statistical difference between the datasets, it was used the Mann-Whitney U-test. This test does not require the assumption of the normal distribution of the data and is suitable for small datasets. Additionally, to omit the course of the error tape first, we used the Benjamin-Hogberg procedure. The confidence level alpha was 5 of 100. We checked the scenarios for the COVID-19 A and B dataset versus healthy control and COVID-19 and AB dataset, influenza as one group versus healthy control. The first scenario shows that 13 features that are statistically significant according to the Mann-Whitney U-test with the false discovery rate correction. The first analysis shows that 1/3 of the created future passed the Mann-Whitney U-test with FDR correction. The most important features are the standard deviation of the activity of the person. It is standard of heart rate to standard deviation number of steps. Meaningful features were also variance, range, residual standard deviation, Shannon entropy, maximum of personal activity and standard deviation, variance, residual standard deviation, range heart rate, likewise Shannon entropy, range and slope of the number of steps during the day. The idea of creating the ratio of the measurements between the extracted features of heart rate to the number of steps occurred to be successful. For the second scenario, half of the features were statistically different. Moreover, with the eliminating error type first, the most powerful were the features obtained based on heart rate and human activity. In the tables, there are summarized the outcomes of the research. The results of the scenario with COVID-19 disease cases from both dataset versus healthy control are presented in table 3. This was provided for the whole set of features. it was achieved 73/100 accuracy and 75/100 sensitivity for Ixjibus, and the mean correlation coefficients was also the highest for Ixjibus, it is 48/100. The best specificity was registered for KNN 77/100. The next scenario was considering the same classification problem, however with the future preselection step. The 20 futures were selected among the whole bunch of them. The outcome of it you can see in the right table 4. The classification results show that Ixjibus achieved 73/100 accuracy, 71/100 sensitivity and 48/100 MCC as the best outcome among other classifiers. The highest specificity has KNN 86/100. Results of the classification of dataset A between COVID-19 cases, influenza versus healthy control are presented in the left table 5. The best accuracy obtained in Ixjibus, 63/100, and Mathieu correlation coefficient was also the best for this classifier, 28/100. The highest sensitivity obtained support vector machine, 90/100, and the best specificity of 67/100 were recognized for the decision tree. The outcome of classification COVID-19 for A and B dataset versus influenza for all cases, it is from dataset A, before the main pandemic and in the middle of the pandemic are shown in the right table 6. The highest accuracy achieved Ixjibus, 67/100, and this classifier had 36 MCC. The random forest had 66/100 sensitivity. The highest specificity was obtained for support vector machine, 73/100. The outcome of the distinction between COVID-19 cases for A and B dataset, influenza A, influenza before the main pandemic, and influenza in the middle of pandemic versus healthy control is shown in the left table 7. The best accuracy of 72/100 was registered for support vector machine. Sensitivity 66/100 was the highest for logistic regression. For the decision tree was observed the highest specificity 90/100 and MCC 47/100. Additionally, multi-class classification between COVID-19 cases and influenza and healthy control for both dataset was performed. The highest 57/100 F1 score was achieved for Ixjibus. Moreover, 58/100 accuracy was also the best for the same classifier, likewise MCC 38/100 was the highest for Ixjibus. To summarize, there were introduced two simple support methodologies in the early stage. One of them was the COVID-19 classification versus healthy control, and the second classification task was the distinction of COVID-19 cases and influenza treated as one group versus healthy control. They were obtained with the usage of machine learning and variables. In total, there were tested and carried out 6 scenarios of classification. There were provided statistical analyses with the indication of the most statistical futures. The possibility to recognize COVID-19 cases from healthy control was achieved on the level of 73/100 balance accuracy with the usage of Ixjibus. Furthermore, the distinction between COVID-19 cases and influenza from healthy control was equal to 72/100 balance accuracy. Moreover, this research is an extension of my previous 2 works. Whereas the limitation of the study is the size of the dataset, likewise the distinction of COVID-19 cases from influenza is equal to 67/100 balance accuracy. This project has received funding from the European Union Horizon ACE 2020, Marie Sklodowska-Curie Innovative Training Networks. Thank you for your attention.